Namaste students. In this session we are going to see the continuation of triangles part 1. So we are moving on to part 2. At the end of the session you will be able to find the length of unknown sides of triangles using BPT. BPT means basic proportionality theorem. We'll see what the theorem says. And you'll also be able to solve the problems, prove the problems using basic proportionality theorem. So we have already seen what similarity means, or what similar triangles means, right? So two triangles are similar if their corresponding angles are equal and their corresponding sides are in the same ratio or proportion, which means when you divide the corresponding sides, you should get the same ratio, same number as ratio. We have already seen this in last video, right? So we'll see what basic proportionality theorem or Thales theorem says. Basic proportionality theorem, also known as Thales theorem, THALES. So it says that if a line is drawn parallel to one side of a triangle to intersect the other two sides in distinct points. So I'm drawing a triangle first. Just a minute. And if I'm drawing a line which is parallel to the third side, so if this line is parallel to the side BC, if I'm drawing it as ABC, right? So DE is the straight line parallel to BC. This is what I'm having. If a line is drawn parallel to one side of a triangle to intersect the other two sides in distinct points, the other two sides are AB and AC, intersecting at D and E respectively. The other two sides are divided in the same ratio, which means AB is divided by D is equal to AC divided by E, which means it says that AD by DB is equal to AE by AC. This is what the theorem says. So this side divided by this side is equal to this side divided by this side. The proportionality will be same. That is why it is known as basic proportionality theorem. Right? So we have already seen that in similar triangles, the sides will be proportional, right? So I'm considering two triangles here. So one is ADE, the other is ABC. I have taken these two triangles from the diagram which is given in the question, from this diagram in the top. Right? So I'm considering two triangles here. One is ADE, the other one is ABC. Right? So we also know that DE is parallel to BC. So can we say that angle ADE is equal to angle ADE is equal to angle ABC? Because corresponding sides, corresponding angles. So similarly, angle AEC is equal to angle, sorry, AED is equal to angle ACB. These two angles are similar, equal. Right? Also, we have angle A is equal to angle A, common in both the triangles. So we can say that by triple A similarity, we'll be seeing these properties later. By triple A similarity, because all the three sides are equal, three angles are equal, we can say that triangle ADE is similar to triangle ABC. So I'm giving a different proof here, which is not in the textbook. So you have another proof in textbook. You can go through the proof there. If you're having any doubts in that proof, you can come to the, you can ask in the group. So this is another method of solving the, proving the theorem using similar triangles, right? So we have two sides similar, right? So it will be like AD by AB is equal to AE by AC is equal to DE by BC. So I'm taking AD and AB. AD by AB will be equal to DE by, these are not equal actually. DE by BC equal to AE by AC. So which means the ratio will be same. You will have some number for all the ratios here, which is a constant. So this is how the similar triangles come, right? So by using this similarity property, I say that these two triangles are similar. So AD by AB is equal to AE by AC, right? So after this, I am taking the reciprocal of this one. So taking reciprocal on both the sides, I have AB by AD is equal to AC by AE. Then, just a minute, I'm not getting the diagram here. Okay, can I say that AB is equal to AD plus DB? Can I write AB as AD plus DB? Similarly, AC, I can write it as AE plus EC, right? So AB is AD plus DB divided by AD plus, sorry, which is equal to AE plus EC divided by AE. So divide this individually, you will have it as AD by AD, which is 1, plus DB by AD, which is equal to AE by AE here, which is 1, plus, why this triangle is open? Okay, fine. So 1 plus DB by AD, which is equal to 1 plus EC by AC. So 3 plus 5 by 3 can be written as 1 plus 5 by 3, right? Which is, I'm writing it as 3 by 3 plus 5 by 3. So 3 and 3 gets cancelled. So similar concept only, I'm using it here. So I can cancel 1 on both the sides. So which makes it DB by AD is equal to EC by AC. So EC by AE. So again, taking reciprocals. We have AD by DB is equal to AE by AC, which is the required proof. Right? So this proof is using similar triangles. That proof given in the textbook is using area of triangles between parallel lines. Right? So go through both the proofs. Whichever is convenient for you, you can use it. So this one also similar. If a line divides any two sides of a triangle in the same ratio, then the line is parallel to the third side, which means they have given that AD by DB is equal to AE by EC. That has been given. You have to prove that these two lines are parallel. Right? So again, you just give a glance about this proof. If you're not getting it, we'll see the proof again in the video session. So we'll go on with the problems here. So I'll do a few of the problems here. You have to try the other few. In the first diagram, I'll take the second subdivision. You have to do the first one. So it has been given that DE is parallel to BC, such that I can use basic proportionality theorem or Thales theorem, right? So A, B, C, D. So AD, I don't know. DB is 7.2, 1.8, 5.4. So DE is parallel to BC. Therefore, by BPT or basic proportionality theorem, we can say that AD by DB is equal to AE by AC. So AD, I don't know. I'll keep it as it is. By DB, I know, which is 7.2. which is equal to 1.8 divided by 5.4, right? So what is AD? AD is equal to 1.8 into 7.2 divided by 5.4, right? So simplifying, you will get the answer, right? Or you can take it as, this is 3 times, this is 2.4 times, so the length of AD is 2.4, right? So similarly, you'll have to try the first subdivision also. In the first subdivision, you don't know the length of AEC, right? AD by DB is equal to AE by EC, same thing, right? So which means that here it has been doubled. Here also it will be doubled, which means 1.5 has been taken as 3. So here also 1 will be converted as 2 here. So your EC length will be 2, right? So second question, moving on to the second one, we have E and F are the points on the sides PQ and PR, respectively of triangle PQR. The following, for each of the following cases, state whether EF is parallel to QR. So this is using corollary. P, Q, R, E and F, right? So if E and F divides the sides PQ and PR proportionally, then by converse of basic proportionality theorem, we can say that EF is parallel to QR, right? So I am taking the first subdivision, you can take do the other subdivisions here. Okay, I'll do the third one instead of doing first one. PQ is equal to 1.28, PR is equal to 2.56. So it's with some decimal points. PE is equal to 0.18, PF is equal to 0.36. This is 0.18. This is 0.36, right? So the total length is 1 point from P to Q, the total length is 1.28. So PE is 0.18. What happens to EQ? 1.28 minus 0.18 is 1.1, right? So similarly, PF by FR, PF is equal to 0.36, PR is equal to 2.56. So 2.56 minus 0.36 will give you 2.2, right? So now you check PE by EQ is equal to, is PE by EQ equal to PF by FR? PE by EQ, what you are getting? 0.18 divided by 1.1. PF by FR is equal to 0.36 divided by 2.2. So cancelling, I'll have it as 0.18 divided by 1.1. So both are same. Therefore, PE by EQ is equal to PF by FR. Therefore, by converse of BPT, we can say that EF is parallel to QR. Right? So the basic proportionality theorem says, if the line is parallel to the, if the drawn line is parallel to the third side, then it divides the other two sides proportionally. Right? So the converse says, if the line joining the points, the line here, if it is dividing the other two sides proportionally, then it is the line which is parallel to the third side. It's the reverse process. That's how the converse theorem says, right? So try the other two subdivisions. Third question, taking the diagram here, 6.18, it is given that LM is parallel to BC and LN is parallel to CD. Right? So consider having it like this. A, B, C, D, M, N, L, L, M, N. Correct? So we are asked to prove that AM by AB is equal to AN by AD. AM by AB is equal to AN by AD. This is what we need to prove. So we have been given that in triangle ABC, LM parallel to BC. That is what given. So by BPT, can we say that? So consider the triangle ABC here. LM is parallel to BC. Therefore, can I say that AL by LC is equal to AM by MB? Keep it as first equation. So similarly, in triangle ADC, we have LN parallel to DC. This line is parallel to this line. Right? So therefore, I can say that again, AL by LC is equal to AN by ND in this case. So I'm keeping it as second equation. So in the in both the first and second equations, I have AL by LC in the left-hand side. Therefore, from 1 and 2, I can say that AM by MB is equal to AN by ND. Right? So I'm doing a small manipulation here. I'm just adding 1 to both sides. So it says that AM by MB plus 1 is equal to AN by ND plus 1. Right? So now you take the LCM, AM plus MB divided by MB is equal to AN by ND, AN plus ND divided by ND. Right? So you will have it as AM plus MB is AB, right? From the diagram, AB by MB is equal to AD by ND. Okay, you have to prove that AM by AB, right? Okay. Nothing else, you just have to reciprocate here before proceeding with the addition here. Just my board is getting hanged. So I am having it as AM by MB, right? So just taking reciprocals, I am having it as MB by AM is equal to ND by AN. So now you add one to both sides. So now you will have it as MB plus one, MB by AM plus one, which is equal to ND by AN plus one. Now you take the LCM, you will have it as AM plus MB divided by AM is equal to AN plus ND divided by AN. So what is AM plus MB? AB, right? AB by AM is equal to AD by AN. Right? So what, now you take the reciprocal again. So you will have it as AM by AB, which is equal to AN by AD, which is the required proof. Right? Hence proof. So again, fourth one in triangle, in the figure, we have DE parallel to AC, DE is parallel to AC, and DF is parallel to AE. DF is here parallel to AE. Prove that BF by FE is equal to BE by EC. So here you have to use two triangles here. So one is triangle ABE. In this case, you have BD by DA is equal to BF by FE. Right? So I'm just giving the hint here. BD by DA is equal to BF by FE in triangle ABE. Similarly, in triangle ABC, I have DB by DA is equal to DE by EC. Similar, BD by DA is equal to BE by EC. So again, I'm having both the left-hand sides are equal, which means I can write it as BF by FE is equal to BE by EC. So that is what we need to prove, right? Hence proof. So DE in this triangle diagram, we have DE is parallel to OQ and DF is parallel to OR. So which means you have to take two triangles here. One is POQ, the other triangle is POR. So you will have it as PD by DO is equal to PE by EQ. Here PD by DO is equal to PF by FR. Which means we can say that P, from the two equations, we can say that PE by EQ is equal to PF by FR. So by corollary or converse of BPD, we can say that EF is a line which is parallel to QR. Right? So you can give a try about that. So in figure 6.21 here, ABC are points on OP, OQ and OR respectively, such that AB is parallel to PQ, OAC. Again, you have to consider three triangles here. So one is POQ, QOR, ROP. So here AB is parallel to PQ, BC is parallel to QR and AC is parallel to PR. Right? So using this, you have to prove that BC is parallel to QR. Okay, it has been given only two conditions, right? So AB is parallel to PQ is given. AC is parallel to PR is given. So I'll consider triangle OPQ first. In triangle OPQ, can I say that OA by AP is equal to OB by BQ? I am considering a triangle POQ. I'm having it like this, right? Sorry, just a minute. It's like this, right? So POQ, AB. So I am writing it as OA by AP is equal to OB by BQ. Right? So similarly, I can say that OA by AP is equal to OC by CR in triangle OPR. OA by AP is equal to OC by CR. So from these two triangles, what can I say? OB by BQ is equal to OC by CR. OB by BQ, I am considering another triangle here. OQRBC. So from these two informations, first equation and second equation, I can say that because left hand side is equal, I can say that OB by BQ is equal to OC by CR. So OB by BQ is equal to OC by CR, which says that BC is parallel to QR. Right? So we'll see the other questions in the next session. If you have time, you can give a try about these questions. And we'll check it. Thank you.